Look at this piece of iron, this copper. How about this aluminum and this zinc? They all have one thing in common, corrosion. What is corrosion? Corrosion is the formation of compounds on the surface of a metal such as oxides, hydroxides, or sulfides. Think of it as an electrochemical oxidation of metal in reaction with an oxidant such as oxygen or sulfates. To observe that this is a redox reaction, take a look at this diagram. The silver right here is a piece of iron metal, and this blob right here is a water droplet. At the anode, the iron gets oxidized into Fe2+, which results to what looks like a deterioration. Electrons that are free at the anode flow through the metal iron to a different area where soluble oxygen in the water accepts electrons to form hydroxide ions, which is the cathode area. Water is a solvent for the Fe2+ that is produced initially and acts as a salt bridge. The iron 2 ions are then combined with the hydroxide ion to form iron 2 hydroxide and is then oxidized by oxygen to form iron 3 hydroxide. The iron 3 hydroxide is then decomposed to form hydrated iron 3 oxide. The hydrated iron 3 oxide is brown in color and is known as rust. The overall equation for the rusting of iron is right here. So basically, corrosion is a galvanic process of the deterioration of a metal as a result of its environment. This leads to damage of material, infrastructures, machines, and release of harmful pollutants into the environment. Further in this video, we will discuss the methods of prevention for corrosion, their respective pros and cons, their application locally and globally, as well as their current status locally and globally.
Methods of prevention for corrosion. Barrier coating. One of the easiest and cheapest ways to prevent corrosion is to use barrier coatings like paint, plastic, or powder. Paint acts as a coating to protect the metal surface from the electrochemical charge that comes from corrosive compounds. The primer coat acts as an inhibitor. The intermediate coat adds to the paint overall thickness, and the finish coat provides resistance to the environmental factors. Barrier coatings aims to prohibit water, oxygen, and other chemicals from making contact with the substrate. Next, hot dip galvanization. This corrosion prevents methods involve dipping steel into molten zinc. The iron in the steel reacts with the zinc to create a tightly bonded alloy coating which serves as protection. The process has been around for more than 250 years and has been used for corrosion protection of things like artistic sculptures and playground equipment. Compared to other corrosion prevention methods, galvanization is known for lower initial cost, sustainability, and versatility. Next, alloyed steels or stainless. Alloyed steel is one of the most effective corrosion prevention methods around, combining the properties of various metals to provide added strength and resistance to the resulting product. Corrosion resistant like nickel, for example, combined with oxidation-resistant chromium results in an alloy that can be used in oxidized and reduced chemical environments. Different alloys provide resistance to different conditions, giving companies greater flexibility. Next, cathodic protection. It protects against galvanic corrosion, which occurs when two different metals are put together and exposed to a corrosive electrolyte. To prevent this, the active sites on the metal surface need to be converted to passive sites by providing electrons from another source, typically with galvanic anodes attached on near the surface. Metal used for anodes include aluminum, magnesium, or zinc. It works by converting unwanted anodic sites on a metal surface to cathodic sites through the application of opposing current. Next, plating. Metallic coatings or platings can be applied to inhibit corrosion as well as to provide aesthetic decorative finishes. Electroplating, a thin layer of metal, often nickel, tin, or chromium, is deposited on the substrate metal in an electrolytic bath. The electrolyte usually consists of water solution containing salt of the metal to be deposited. Next, mechanical plating. Metal powder can be cold welded to a substrate metal by tumbling the part along with the powder and glass beads. In a treated aqueous solution, mechanical plating is often used to apply zinc or cadmium to small metal parts. Next, anodic protection. Anodic protection involves coating the iron alloy steel with the less active metal such as tin. Tin will not corrode, so the steel will be protected as long as the tin coating is in place. This method is known as anodic protection because it makes the steel the anode of an electrochemical cell. Anodic protection is often applied to a carbon steel storage tank used to store sulfuric acid and 50% caustic soda. In these environments, cathodic protection is not suitable due to extremely high current requirements. Lastly, passivation. In passivation, a lead coat of protective material such as metal oxide creates a protective layer over the metal which acts as a barrier against corrosion. The formation of this layer is affected by environmental pH, temperature, and surrounding chemical composition. A notable example of passivation is the Statue of Liberty. It is coated with a blue-green patina caused by several chemical reactions, which serves to protect the copper metal underneath.
So, of course, there are pros and cons in the methods used. First is the barrier coatings. Its pros is it protects metal surfaces against rust, oxidation, corrosion, and it also protects metal from other chemicals. While the cons is it is brittle and it has poor adhesion. Next is the hot dip galvanization. Its pros is it makes the steel highly durable, it will not be corroded easily, and it will not get contaminated by the effect of other chemicals. While the cons is it deforms thin structures because of heating, and it's also costly. Third is the alloyed steel. The pros is it solidifies the steel even more, it has higher ductility, and it also has better machinability. While the cons is it can be brittle at high stress level, and it's very expensive. Fourth is the cathodic protection. Its pros is it stops corrosion in contaminated concrete, and it can be used on various types of metal structures. While the cons is it is not effective in higher resistivity environments. Fifth is the plating. Its pros is it has high corrosion resistance, heat resistance, and it has increased strength and hardness. While the cons is it is costly, time-consuming, and it's also a cause of pollution. Next is the inhibitors. Its pros is it decreases the corrosion rates in pipelines, reduces cost of repair when it is damaged by corrosion, and it extends lifespan of the equipment. While the cons is, whenever there is a low concentration of inhibitor, it increases the rate of corrosion. Next is the anodic protection. The pros is, it can also decrease corrosion rate and protects equipment used to handle sulfuric acid. While the cons is, if you are not careful, it tends to have excessive current, leading to accelerated corrosion. And lastly is the passivation. The pros is it's environment friendly, does not emit harmful nitrogen oxide vapors, and it can also clean the metal. While the cons is using the wrong passivation could cause damage to a metal.
Applications of corrosion to our daily lives, both locally and globally. What is the application of corrosion to us locally or globally that we can find in our daily lives? So we must first define corrosion as dangerous, and the next one would be costly. For corrosion is a dangerous and extremely costly problem because of it. Buildings can, bridges can collapse, oil pipelines break, chemical plants leak, and bathroom floods. Corroded electrical contacts can cause fires and other problems, and corroded medical implants may lead to blood poisoning and air pollution that has caused corrosion damage to works of art around the world. Corrosion threatens the disposal of radioactive waste that must be stored in containers for 10,000 of years. So basically, we can see that this type of process or chemical process have impacted the world around the world in different types of cases, either minor or major catastrophic damage. Overall, the application of this can be defined as described earlier, dangerously and costly to the environment.
Lastly, here are the current status and happenings about corrosion. Impedance measurements about corrosion have been discussed. In the recent years, the problem of linearization of electrochemical process and the possibility of realization of impedance measurement in nonlinear conditions have been discussed. Classical impedance spectroscopy can provide information concerning only before and after the corrosion process. However, since the electrode impedance is measured continuously in potentiodynamic conditions, DEIS allows to investigate the preceding corrosion process in time. Hence, one can obtain very detailed characteristics of the examined corrosion system. Some corrosion have been regarded as a stochastic process. It has been reported that some corrosion, such as pitting corrosion, are regarded as a stochastic process of the native oxide films. Since the fluctuations in potential or current associated with the pitting process can be easily observed in the experimental data, electrochemical noise measurement has been newly used for monitoring as well as studying corrosion process. Many researchers have investigated the pitting corrosion in terms of statistical variation in the pitting potential and pit embryo density. In addition, the pitting corrosion has been described with fractal geometry. Next, gross national product increases because of the advances made to reduce the cost of corrosion. Over the last two decades, economic growth and price inflation have increased the gross national product more than fourfold. If nothing else had changed, the cost of metallic corrosion would have risen to almost $350 billion annually. Advances have been made in the use of stainless steels, coated metals, and more protective finishes. Moreover, several substitutions of materials made primarily for reasons of weight reduction have also reduced corrosions. The updated study shows that the total cost of metallic corrosion was reduced by some 14% of the gross national product. Avoidable corrosion, which was 40% of the total, is now estimated to be 35%, but still accounts for slightly more than $100 billion per year. And locally, corrosion has been a major problem in the Philippines. In the Philippines, the corrosion of plant equipment and structure within and around geothermal power generation facilities can be a major problem due to the presence of salts, hydrogen sulfide, and silicates in the geothermal water, which cause localized corrosion and scale formation in wells and casings in and power generating equipment. Material selection is crucial and it needs long-term risk-based inspection to achieve significant cost savings. This has recently been demonstrated in the Philippines, currently the world's second largest producer of geothermal energy.